Sweet Dreams are made of this mum-daughter duet. The apple hasn't fallen far from the tree, has it, with Eurythmics star Annie Lennox passing on her incredible talents to her daughter.
Yeah, and now Lola Lennox has gone from keeping her songwriting a secret from her mum to stepping into the spotlight, releasing two singles this year and an EP set for 2022. And we're delighted to welcome Lola to the show. Hello, Lola.
Hi,
thanks for speaking to us.
Thanks so much for having me.
It's our pleasure.
Absolutely
our pleasure. Firstly, you grew up in a household with extremely high musical expectations. What kind of impact did that have on you and your own songwriting with your mom as a kid?
I'd say it's a little bit of a blend of two things. When I was younger, it felt a little intimidating. I had quite a high bar ahead of me, but that also gave me a lot of discipline and desire to meet my potential and bring out the best of myself. So I worked really hard to try to get to a place musically that I felt expressed who I am as a person and that I thought people would enjoy listening to the music. So it's a little bit of both.
Yeah. Your mum actually co-produced your track Love Like That. In fact, let's take a listen to that now.
Like a bridge over trouble.
So what was it like being in the studio with your mum? Obviously, you grew up around your mum, who's an incredible artist, but were there creative tussles in the studio where you were like, no, mum, this is me, I'm doing it my way?
You know what? I think we both saw going into the studio as like a professional environment. Mm-hmm. And you go into the room and there's a certain level of respect of trying to bring the best out of the music. I really respect what she has to offer. She respects what I have to offer. And it was actually a lovely way of getting to know each other creatively and what the other person would bring to the table. So we kind of got to know each other in a new dynamic and we didn't have any tussles. Like we get on, we're both quite easygoing people, we get on well. So thankfully it was all good.
Aww. Well, that's awesome. Yeah, obviously you know what you're doing. That track there is superb. That's so good, huh?
Thanks.
We also saw in the intro you performed your song Wherever You Go with the BBC Concert Orchestra. Unbelievable. Mm-hmm. That was all done virtually. How complex is it putting something like that together?
First of all, it was an incredible project to be part of. To get to hear my song performed by the BBC Orchestra was like a dream come true. And it was a little complex. Like, they sent me the music, which I could just practice along to, and they pieced the pieces together and it seemed to work. So it was a really lovely thing to be part of and to see all these musical professionals during this time that was so difficult for everybody. We're all stuck at home, but we're all contributing musically together to, you know, put a piece of music together to make people smile. It was great.
Oh, and there were so many big smiles when you put that together and put that out to the world. Lola, where do you hope your music career takes you?
I just want to make as much great music as I can. Nothing lights me up more than singing. It's such a special thing. It touches my soul. So I just want to be writing music, continuing to share songs that touch people and light people up and make people feel something. So whatever that path may be, I hope that everyone who listens to the songs enjoys them or feels something emotionally and it connects to something inside of them.
Your mum was very instrumental in the feminist movement. Is it a heavy kind of burden to carry? Does it feel like you're carrying on a legacy then on continuing that incredible feminist activism within the music industry? And do you think that the industry has changed? And in what ways has it changed since your mum was at the fore?
I think she's always given me and my sister space to come to causes authentically with a genuine interest. So I think there was a time when I was younger where I was definitely focusing primarily on my music and growing and building my artistry. And as I grew up a little, I've come to be, you know, much more interested, and I see and recognize the need for women like myself, or all women, to support this women's rights. So it's been a development for me, and you know, it's something that is so important for us all to wake up to. And you know, I take it seriously that I'm a female musician in an industry, and I want to express music that empowers all women, especially young girls who think that they might want to be creative, they might want to be artists. If I inspire one girl to do that, like, that just means the world to me.
Fantastic. That is superb, yeah? You're very much an artist in everything that you're doing. You work with Will Gregory from Golf Rap also for a TV show narrated by Oscar winner Elupide Nyong'o. Do you want to do more TV projects?
If something that felt right came up, I would absolutely love to. It's a totally different way and perspective of making music. You're making something for screen to bring out a story. And we made music for Serengeti, so it's about animals on the Serengeti. And it was more orchestral and lush. And I felt like I was back in my school choir days, because the singing style was different. But it was a great challenge and a lot of fun.
Aw, well, look out for Lola's EP next year. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Best of luck. We can't wait to see what you do next, Lola.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. Take care. Keep up the great work.